Hello, Spider Peeps. Okay, so in a previous video, I used a pico-mac on one of these little RP2040-Zeros. Now, few people have asked about the UF2 file for this because I had to modify the UF2 file, the standard one, because if you remember, on the RP2040, we didn't have access to the standard output pins that a standard Pi Pico would have. We've got them through the back there, but that was going to be a bit too hard. So we actually changed the firmware a little bit to do that. And I didn't show that on the video. So I'm going to do that on this video now and show you how you can build it on a Mac. But a lot of these things will probably be exactly the same on a PC. And I'll try and point out where areas where I think it wouldn't be the same on the PC. But there are a few gotchas that got me, so let's get to it. On the screen here, we've got Matt Evans. He's the genius who did this UMac, which was a Macintosh 128 emulator, and also this pico-mac, which is what we're going to use today. Now, this pico-mac does actually use that UMac, so we'll go through and set it up and see what we need to do. Search menu first, and the first thing we need to type is terminal, because a lot of this we will do in the terminal. So this goes to a home directory, which is something that if you just use a Mac, not with a terminal, you might not be familiar with this, but let's just go into the documents folder. Oops, good start, isn't it? Capital D. Documents. Okay, I'm in there, and I'm going to create a folder in there. And let's call it Pico Stuff. All right. So that's fine. And let's go into this. So CD Pico Stuff. All right. Now, if we go now into our documents now, we can see Pico Stuff there. So that's cool. Okay. That's what we've created. Let's now go and install Homebrew. So if you go to brew.sh, if you haven't installed Homebrew on the Mac, if we type in brew on here, gives you a result like that. You've installed it in the past. It doesn't come with the Mac. If you don't get that, it's literally you just copy that from there, paste it into the terminal, and hit return. It might ask you for your password a couple of times, but it'll install Brew for you. That will help you a lot. The other thing that Brew will do when you install it is it'll install Git for you. Now, we need Git to grab stuff from GitHub to access repositories, which sounds complicated, but actually it's not, especially if you're just cutting and pasting. So now if we type Git, it should, because we've installed Homebrew, also give us something. If when you type Git, it comes up, I need to install Xcode, then there's something missing. A bit of a complicated bit, so let's just clear this again. So the first thing we can do is use Brew. Brew install, and then we need to install this extra thing, which is called SDL2, hopefully, if I remembered it right. So it should go off and do that. Does all manner of magic. And that's one of the libraries that UMac needs, but it will do that for us. So while that's downloading, let me just show you something else that we need to download. If we go to this here, pico-mac.bluescuzzy.com, the guys at BlueScuzzy have created this thing that automatically creates a UF2 for you. So if you just have a Pico and not one of these RP2040-Zeros, a standard Pico, you can just get a demo disk from somewhere, one of the Macintosh repositories, upload it, and then press that, and it will generate the UF2 for you. But we've got to change things, so this is why we're going through the complex mechanism. But while we're here, download this demo disk. Get that downloaded, because that'll be useful for you. I did notice, I don't think this is a secure download. So if you click it and nothing happens, I think you have to do save link as, and then it will let you download it. Do save then. All right. And it will, when you try and do that, it will say, hey, this isn't safe. There you go. But just say keep it and it will download it for you. So if I go to my downloads, so I've just got that demo disk downloaded. We can open this up actually, because we'll need it. So we just double click on this on a Mac. It should automatically expand for us. And we've got two things in here, but it's this demo disk that we'll need later on when we're setting it up. Okay, SDL2 has installed now, which is what we need. So now we start messing about with Git. So let's go back to GitHub, Matt Evans' site, and let's go to pico-mac. And if we go to this red code button and just copy that, all we've got to do, click copy that, then go across here and do git clone and paste in what you've copied. This will pull all of the files from this repository, this GitHub thing, into yours. So if I now do ls to look what's there, we've got pico-mac. If I do ls to look inside it, pico-mac, you'll find there's some other bits in it. We've got to do something in pico-mac in a minute. But while we're in our top level pico stuff directory, let's also grab the pico SDK. So this is GitHub Raspberry Pi pico-sdk. So let's just copy that again, and it's the same drill. So let's just clear it. We're in that pico stuff directory. So we do git clone and paste that one in. And clear it again and just have a look. So now we've got that Pico SDK in there, which we'll need as well later on. So now let's go into CD Pico-mac, have a look in there. And there's some things in this external that we've got to do some stuff with. So now I'm going to go back to the instructions on Pico-mac. And if we go down a little bit, it says after we've done it, after we've cloned it, if we just copy that bit there and paste that in, and that pulls down some other bits that are in that external directory for us. Quite quick to do that. Checking where we are, we're still in that pico-mac directory. So now we've got to go into this external umac, which we've just pulled down with that command. So cd external, and we can shortcut it umac to go straight in there. So we're in this directory, and then we do make memsize equals to OA. I missed this out. I actually built UMAC by downloading it separately. I didn't realize it was in this directory, and that caused me a lot of confusion, even though actually it's quite clear on this, but I was stupid. So let's try that. All right, comes up with some warnings, but actually no errors. So that's good. If you get errors saying it can't find sdl.h, is because you didn't do that brew install SDL2 earlier. Done it now. So that's made the file for us, as it said, following the instructions again. So from the top level Pico UMAC directory. Okay, so in the UMAC directory now, what we've got to do is run this main bit here. But we also need, so looking at this, this is how we run it. We need the Mac plus V3 ROM and also the disk. I'm just going to add these into this directory. So we've got the disk already in our downloads. So let's take that disk and just copy that and then go into, there we are. So I'm just going to paste that in there. So that's demo disk. And now we've got to find the ROM. Okay, so Macintosh repository holds the trusted ROMs here. Well, let's just click on that, and there's various bits and bobs here. It's all a bit confusing. That this is the one we need, but I think we have to download all of it. So down the bottom, there's a download bit. So they're not very big. So hopefully that'll come down in a couple of seconds. Go into my downloads ready and unzip that. And in the 128K ROMs, I think it is. Yeah, we've got this version 3 that ends in 172. So I'm just going to copy that and then go back into our UMAC directory and paste that in there. And for ease, I'm just going to change that to rom.bin. And I probably should change that demo to disk.bin as well while I'm here. Use bin. So if we go up here now, an ls on that, we should have the ROM and the disk there ready for us. Okay, hope you're still with me. So now we run this and let's see whether it works. So I do /main minus r for the ROM, if ROM.bin, and then d for the disk, disk.bin. I think that's all we need. Let's just press return. Okay, so we've done something right. We've got this working on our Mac. Okay, a Mac working on the Mac. It's got very inception, hasn't it? All right, let's just close that. Now, I think we can't close this because we can't get to it. So Command Q gets you out of that. We know that's working now, but we've just got to do something else with it. So we've got all the things we need. If we now go back to these instructions. So we go back to the pico-mac directory and go into this include, and here we've got this hw.h. Now this is the important bit. This is the whole point of what we do in this. So if we open this now, sometimes you can just click on it. Yeah, so I've double clicked on that, and this is where this magic happens. All right, so this is where it sets the pins on our device. So the GPIO LED pin, so on my stuff, I've got that on pin 28, so that's that one here. So I'm going to set that. This is optional, but I think setting it is useful because there's no onboard LED, standard LED. There's just this RGB addressable LED on it. So let's change that to 28. And then these, as you know, start at pin 9. And this is important. This was an issue that I had. So we need to go 9, 10. We don't ignore clock. We set that as 11. And then the horizontal sync, that last one, we fit to 12. Now, if you wanted it on any other pins along this, if you didn't want to use those bottom pins, assuming these aren't being used, I think it does use 1 and 2 for something, some UART things. If you want to use any of the other pins, they've got to be consecutive. This is where you'll edit them. And just save that, okay. So it's important to do that before we do the build. So let's follow this here. So first of all, I've got to make the build directory. And we should see it appear down there. There it is. So let's go into it, CD build. And I'm just going to go into it here as well, just so that we see what it's doing. So now I've got to set this path here. But if I just do Pico SDK path equals, although it goes in, it doesn't seem to like it. So I discovered that I needed to put export there to make sure it goes in as a variable. So let's run that. And now while we're in there, we do C make double dot, which takes the files from the directory above it. And then we have to add the option. So this is where we add the D mem size equals 208 again. All right, so that should do everything it needs to. That was pretty quick, wasn't it? So that's that first step of that. So now we have to do the ROMs. So we create the ROM by running this. All right, so we need to go back into the main directory again, CD double dot. Yep, so back into there. And then we run this command, which should takes the ROM file, which we should have in here somewhere. Whoops, that's the build. So it takes that ROM file there, and it also takes the disk file as well. And the WROM outputs that file. So this should load the pico-mac up, hopefully, if we've done it right, for a second, and then gets rid of it. But it's created a ROM file for us. Okay, we've already got the disk image from earlier. So now we go through these. So we need to create this directory called inkbin. So mkdir inkbin. And this command here sort of takes the ROM file and copies it as a header file. I think XXD must encode it somehow. Try that yet. So it doesn't do much. And then we're using the internal disk image. So that's the image we downloaded from the disk file at the start. So let's do that. So they're quite simple. LS ink bin. We can see it's put those two files in there. So we're still in the main pico-mac directory. So we should now, if all is good, be able to go make minus C build. And let's go into the build directory here. So this is saying make all the files in that pico-mac directory, put them in the build directory. And I don't know what minus C does. Use a C compiler probably. I don't know. So that's that build directory. So let's run that. So it's definitely doing something now. You see, it's creating all the targets. One of those is a UF2 thing, so that's good. So hopefully we'll get a UF2 at the end of this. And we can watch it down there. And as it creates things bit by bit, we should be able to see things appearing there, I hope. There's that video PIO appeared. And it's finished. So here we have the UF2 file. Lovely. All right. So all I've got to do now is plug this back into the Mac and copy this file across. So for this one, when it's plugged in, I like to hold the reset down, hold the boot down, let go of the reset, let go of the boot, and that will pop it up as a USB drive, and then we can drag the file across into it. All right. So I hope that's been a useful demonstration of the UF2 file and how to create it. how we can modify it to use the pins that we're using on this RP2040-Zero. But watch out for the next video, because the next video I'm going to be making the PCB for this. So I hope this has helped. So please subscribe to see the next instalment. Bye!
Game over, man! Game over!